First off, I have my Milwaukee gloves in here. I love these Milwaukee gloves because you can get a pair of these for less than $10. And protecting your hands for $10 versus having a $1,000 or over $1,000 medical bill because you got a big cut, you know, now you got to get stitches or you got to get something re-sewn back on, you know, for less than $10 a week, you can have you a good pair of gloves. And I like them because when I put them on, I can still move my fingers around. A lot of guys say that they have trouble moving their fingers around in their gloves because the gloves be so tight, you know. So, Milwaukee gloves. Next thing is I have a Milwaukee Fuel. I love this Milwaukee Fuel because it's very powerful and the battery is so small. And practically I use this for pretty much everything. A lot of times I won't carry my large 18 volt drill because I can do everything with this small little impact right here. And I just have a little Malco tip in it where one size is 1/4 inch and the other size is 5/16. So you can just you can flip it around to the 1/4 inch side and you can flip it back around to the 5/16 side. I love that little tip because it requires me to carry less. Next thing, I just carry a Milwaukee headlamp. You know, it takes 3 batteries and does the job pretty well there. Pretty inexpensive enough to where if you break one or lose one, you can easily replace it. So, Milwaukee headlamp. Next thing is mostly I only use Klein tools. I've been using Klein tools since I've been in the trade for about 18 years. So just Milwaukee needle nose. My Dykes diagonal cutters. Keep my pair of Kleins, my Lymans, and Klein strippers. Now these are strippers, and also too they have a crimping tool, and they also have a tool to where you can cut off certain size bolts. You may have a bolt that's too long, and you can screw it in. You can see where I have one part of a bolt that's stuck, but basically you screw it in the backside and you can cut it off if that bolt's too long. And like I said, you have that crimping head right here for your different size crimps. And I really like this Lennox razor blade. So it holds other razor blades right in this little section right here. Right here, holds little razor blades. I actually like how this feels in my hand, you know? And yeah, it's just a good little knife. I love it. So the next thing I have is a cleaning brush for cleaning condenser coils or evaporator coils. A lot of times they have a lot of dust on them, on that coil. So this is what I use to clean that outside unit before I spray it down or before I clean that the evaporator unit before I clean it up. Service wrench. So this is a Klein service wrench, 1/4 inch, 3/8. The other side is 3/16 and 5/16. So this comes in real handy. So you can turn it around and you can use it for that side also. So, no, I'm sorry. This is the service side. I'm sorry. You can't use it on both sides, but this is the service side right there. That tip. So let's see if there's anything else down here. So I just have a temperature gauge. I use this on the outside of my condensing unit to get the ambient temperature outside. So next item is I have a core removal tool. This is made by Yellow Jacket. Really heavy duty, nice quality also. next thing I have down here is a just charging tee. Another service wrench, just angled, it's a Klein. And last but not least, I just have a few extra tips. So you saw I have that long tip that I keep in my bag. I have that long one. I keep a Phillips and also keep just a few extra spare Malco short tips. So I have all those in my bag also. And I normally keep a few B caps down in the bottom here. So I just have one right now. So that's everything for the front of the bag. Hey guys, let me say this. This Vito MCT, this is only for troubleshooting. This is not for new installs. So this bag is meant to be a lightweight, versatile bag that I can carry going up a ladder onto a roof, or going on top of a building, or going into someone's home, going into an attic. So this is not gonna be a video that shows what you would need for a full install. You're not gonna see torches with this. You won't see any of that other stuff. This is just simply for diagnosing a bad blower motor, diagnosing a run capacitor. So I just wanted to clarify that before someone says, well, why don't you have this or why don't you have that? Please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. It really helps your channel grow. If you can, say what's up on the comment. I'd love to hear from you all. And if you guys can you please hit the thumbs up button, the like button. Let's see if we can get this video to maybe, you know, 1,000 likes. Hey, thank you. Stay tuned for the video. Okay guys, back side of the bag now. Or you know what, let's start right here. So I just keep a few screws in this top portion right up here, just a few self-tapping screws. Alligator clips for testing. May have to jump a circuit, bypass a circuit to see if it's working. So we'll go to the inside of the bag. Oh yeah. So, okay, so man, this field piece meter, I love this field piece meter. This field piece meter is the This is the SC460. I love this meter because I can do so much with this meter. I mean, I can't say nothing but good things about this meter. I have other electrical meters to where they're so big and bulky, and then they have less functions. But this is a value pack meter that's roughly between, I think I paid maybe like around like $250, I think, for this meter. A while back, and man, it's been one of the best investments for doing air conditioning heating troubleshooting. So let's keep on moving. Put that right there. Okay, where else do we want to start? So I always use these Milwaukee insulated screwdrivers. Because a lot of times I'm working around live parts. So if I'm sticking a screwdriver in there, I do not want to stick a metal screwdriver in there. I'll stick one of these insulated ones in there. So next thing I keep is just this is a Klein 11-in-1. Has the nut driver ends. It has the security key ends. Of course the Phillips, turn around. Get the Phillips and the flathead, and of course there's a nut driver right there. Well, I'm trying to get it out, but it's pretty okay. Well, doesn't want to come out now, but anyway, right here there's another nut driver right here. So I love this. It's a fantastic tool also. So I have just a small Husky. This is another security tip that I keep in here. Or star key, star bits. I use this for my thermostats. Small Klein, little trim. He has a Phillips and a flathead on both sides. So it has a different size on that side. Okay, so I use this level. It's small enough to where I can have it in my bag. I use it to see the degree of angle that's on my drain pipe, or if my furnace in the attic is level, I use it for that. So I use this to, when you're trying to troubleshoot a furnace and you need to have that circuit on, but you need that door closed. So this will close that door. This is made by Subco. It closes that switch on the door. This is just a little troubleshooting chart that I use. Comes in handy, especially for a technician that's still learning. So now, I have these. I love the field piece Bluetooth. These Bluetooth right to your phone. These are the your low and your high side pressure probes. So instead of lugging around the old school hoses and gauges, you can use these, and it'll Bluetooth right to your phone. It'll give you the pressures right on your phone on the field piece app. So those are the pressure probes. Now here we have the field piece psychrometer. Same thing, Bluetooth, gives you the temperature split, gives you the temperature of your return and the temperature of your supply side temperatures. Okay, so these are the field piece pipe clamps. So these will give you the temperature of your pipe clamps. I'm sorry, of your copper, your high side and your low side. These will give you your temperature. Also Bluetooth as well. Let's keep a pair of channel locks in here. And at the bottom here, just keep a few B caps. You can never have enough B caps. Let's see if anything else down there. That's it. Okay, so that's the both front and side. That's the both front and back. So now let's go to the side real quick. So on this side, I just keep a hot stick, Widowmaker, no touch testing device, a marker, and an inspection mirror. If you need to look in your evaporator coil, if you're looking in your condenser coil, you're trying to check for a leak somewhere, and this extends out, and like I said, it has a mirror on the end, so if you kind of look behind and see if there's a leak with your soap bubbles, you know, this is a very good tool.